Keeping up with our motto, let learning be a joy and teaching a pleasure. Here we are with the remote teaching and learning process to bridge the gap. Happy learning, students! For Standard Senior KG, subject story, topic The Foolish Donkey. Children, today we are going to learn a new story. The name of the story is The Foolish Donkey. One day, a donkey stumbled across a lion's skin. He decided to put it on. I'll be the king of jungle for a day, he thought. All the animals that he met ran away at the sight of the lion's fur. The donkey felt very proud and powerful. All the animals were scared as they thought that he was the real lion. Along came a zebra. The donkey said to himself, "That zebra is always calling me a fool. Let me teach him a lesson. We'll see who's the bigger fool." The donkey threw himself into the zebra's path and let out what he expected to be a powerful roar. Unfortunately, the zebra heard the donkey braying. The zebra laughed on the donkey's face. He said, "If you hadn't opened your mouth, you would have fooled me. Didn't you know that clothes may disguise a fool, but his words will always give him away?" So children, the moral of the story is, do not imitate others. Children, now let us revise some question and answers. Question number 1. What did the donkey find in the jungle? Answer. The donkey found a lion's skin in the jungle. Question number 2. How was the donkey dressed up? Answer. The donkey was dressed up as a lion. Question number 3. Why did the donkey become bold? Answer. The donkey became bold as the other animals thought that he was a real lion and they feared him. Question number 4. What did the zebra hear when the donkey opened his mouth to roar? Answer. The zebra heard the braying sound of the donkey when the donkey opened his mouth to roar. Now let us learn some words and their meanings. Stumbled. To lose one's balance. Decided. To make a final choice or judgment. Powerful. Ability to control people or things. Disguise. Different appearance in order to hide one's identity. Thank you, children.